my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I met you. I was breathing
the night. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 1 through 10, as Mary sees it. How to obey Christ in daily living. Christian believer, listen to and do what those who brought you to salvation in Christ tell you to do. They are your spiritual parents and His delegate. If you accept their instruction and the structure of life they advise as best, you will be entitled to the same blessing that the God of the angel armies gave to the children of Israel. Honor your father and mother so that you may have a long, happy, and productive life. This is the first of the 10 rules for right living that carries a promise for this earthly life. Spiritual parents. This goes for your physical children as well. Don't intentionally irritate or frustrate. Don't make trivial, illogical, shameful, or abusive demands of them. Also, don't play favorites or ostracize any of them. Rather, discipline yourself with the godly character of tender, loving kindness. As you assist and guide your physical and spiritual children, if you have a boss or a supervisor at your job, or, as in some places in the world, are an actual slave, do what your boss says to do. Respect their authority. Imagine how you would behave if Jesus Himself was your boss, and act as if He actually is. Don't just follow the rules when your boss is watching or to make people like you. If you behave in this manner, your heart will be pure towards your boss or bosses. And regardless of the outcome on the job, God will give you favor and ensure that you are taken care of. Bosses, slave owners, supervisors. Act kindly towards those under your authority, showing compassionate interest in them and concern for their well-being and success. Stop threatening them and demeaning them. Keep this in the front of your mind as you deal with those you have authority over, that Christ is master of both you and them. He neither counts you as better nor your subordinate as less. Both you and your subordinate are ultimately subject to Christ, here and forevermore.